Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. This is Deep Cats Reactions, and my name's Greg, and I think I'm finally gonna dip into Midnight Oil. You know, I mean, they were famous here in the U.S. You know, they had a couple of big frickin' hits, and I've heard those, and they're good and all that, but that's all I've heard. So this is Midnight Oil and Warumpi, and the song is Black Fellow, White Fellow, and Dead Heart. I guess they go into a second song, I'm not sure. But this isn't really live, you know. I mean, it's a video and all that. But I thought it was amusing, you know, because first of all, the term black fella, you couldn't even say that in the United States, and white fella, you know, people would probably be just weirded out about that. But yeah, it's you know, it's a different thing. It's obviously really just part of the Australian lexicon, you know. So. Anyway, I thought I'd check it out. So here we go. Midnight Oil and Warumpi, Black Fella, White Fella, and Dead Heat.
Don't speak your tongue. White man came to everyone. We don't serve your country, don't serve your king.
White man, listen to the songs we sing. White man came, talk everything. Down, speak your tongue. White man came to everyone. Well, don't need protection, don't need your hand. Keep your promise on where we stand. Say we'll listen, we'll understand.
That was really freaking good, man. That was far, far and away better than what made the charts here in the U.S., as far as I'm concerned. You know, it had everything I wanted. I mean, it had politics, great melodies, hot guitar, great mix. You know, it was cool how, particularly in the beginning, you know, they were changing up places in the band, and, you know, the other guys were out there, and, you know, people are changing what they play, and it was really neat. You know, it was very, very cool. And then the, you know, the second song, it was, you know, all them. But at one point, they brought in that trombone, which was really cool. But, you know, and I've got to admit, I did like the video there with all the imagery. It actually was, it did enhance the song, which rarely happens, but it truly did. So I don't know, man, that was great. And I'm really glad that I listened to that instead of, you know, just going with what my impression was of these guys, you know, because they were okay. You know, I liked them okay, but they were never, you know, an overwhelming group as far as I was concerned. But yeah, that's a nice little dipping the toe in the water. So I will listen to a bunch more of those. I mean, we didn't, you know, what hits the charts here in the U.S. is what some record company decides is going to be the song off the album. And it's always such bullshit. You know, there's been a lot of times where, you know, the producers and the record company has, you know, put out the A side, you know, this is going to be the hit. We know this is going to be the hit. And there will be the B side that ends up getting played. And, you know, but that's just a, you know, casual example. It happens all the time. You know, the record companies think they can control the artist, the music, and they so often don't have a freaking clue, you know. So, I don't know. This was good. I enjoyed that, and I'll definitely play some more of them. So, anyway, I will be back, and hit like, subscribe, and we will see y'all later. Bye-bye.